Alright, you geisha looking bastards, here are some quick starting tips for Nioh 2. But before we do that, nope, no time wasting, let's go. Tip number 1. Ranged weapons are godlike for clearing stages. There is danger around every corner and half the time you won't see it coming due to enemies being concealed or at high places. What you do is move slowly and observe. Enemies are everywhere, and one headshot means potentially one enemy less, making encounters much easier. Some enemies are wearing heavy helmet, which means arrows will be deflected, and in that case matchlock or hand cannon should be used. So move slowly and get rid of the enemies from as far as possible, because that way you're gonna have much easier time getting to the bosses. Replenish ammo after each mission. Also, buy salt. Gonna explain why salt in the next tip. Replenishing ammo is not automatically done, so go to blacksmith and buy arrows, bullets, cannonballs and throwing dildos, whatever you need. During the mission you can further replenish ammo by going to make offering feature at shrine and exchanging divine rice for bullets, arrows, elixirs and other random and non-random stuff at Kodama Bazaar. Divine Rice is obtained by donating equipment to Kodamas. While at Shrine, choose Healer option from Kodama Blessing Screen to get as many elixirs as possible during missions in region where Kodamas have been found. This helps tremendously. Yokai's Dark Realm, Yokai Pools and other bullocks. I don't need to tell you that Ki Pulse is essential. It clears Yokai Pulse and speeds up Ki recovery. Duh. Without Ki Pulses you are a walking Bozo the Clown, and around the corner lurks nothing but death and frustration. In Nioh 2, next to Yokai Pulse are Dark Realms that are removed by defeating specific enemy or by destroying some kind of giant Amrita or node or statue or whatever. Depends on the situation. In Dark Realms, your Ki recovery is significantly lowered. This is especially frustrating against bosses and powerful Yokai enemies. To counter that, use Sacred Water. It speeds up Ki recovery. Now we get to salty part. Salt is amazing against Yokai enemies. It obliterates their Ki, making them extremely vulnerable to getting staggered, so now every tough Yokai fight becomes much easier. Now Yokais are becoming salty, thanks to this trick. Not you. New weapon Switchglaive is amazing. It scales off of one of the most important attributes, which is magic. Magic is amazing in Nioh 1, and it still is in Nioh 2. So by having a weapon whose damage scales from magic attribute, developers have basically said screw it, here is the best weapon for beginners to have some fun. This leaves so many other points that can be distributed into heart, courage, constitution and stamina if necessary, to boost ki recovery and health. Next to that you get to use a ton of spells that can help tremendously. Switchblade works amazing in mid stance. Just spam quick attacks. It has spear-like reach, but much faster combos, and is generally now better version of spear, which was the best beginner weapon in Nioh 1. Great thing about mid stance is that it reduces ki usage when blocking, meaning you can block more. So you get great offense and defense in one stance with Switchblade. Using Spirit Stone fills up Amrita gauge, since Amrita gauge is generally filled by receiving Amrita from fallen enemies. So save those stones for before boss fights to enter the fight at your maximum, meaning you can turn into Yokai again when needed. There are also various boosts that you can get by having your Amrita gauge full through stats on equipment, soul cores and guardian spirits. prestige points. Even though game explains those, it is very easy to forget about them. So every once in a while, go to title screen and use those points to get small boosts that will eventually become more significant. There are three stances in Nioh. During early game, low stance is almost useless, unless you are a very experienced player that can use flux and switch stances at all times. Low stance is used to reduce ki usage when dodging, but unfortunately damage done while in low stance is very low, which can lead to fights being unnecessarily prolonged. Later in the game you can up the damage from low stance by using specific active skills combined with spells, but early on I would advise you staying clear of it. Low stance offers high mobility and it is best used with builds that do not use weapon attacks and skills that much, but instead use lots of ninja tools and spells to dish out damage. However, that is not that viable very early on because of usage and points limitations. So high stance for clearing weaker enemies and combination of mid and high stance for tougher ones early on, it's all you need. By going to the dojo you can complete way of the something missions that grant various rewards. They are unlocked as you progress. Definitely do those because there are really nice rewards for doing them. At this screen you can also reset skill points by pressing triangle button. Some skills have tiers. If there are upwards arrows on top of the skill, it means it can be upgraded, which boosts effectiveness of that skill. For example, by leveling up Steel Talisman, Jutsu cost is decreased and the mount preparable is increased. Very important missable thing to know. Skills can be customized and modified. There are specific skills that boost custom active skills in Samurai 3. These can be applied to any active skill by going to skill customization screen and pressing square on a skill you wish to modify. Note that only one modification can be applied per weapon, so you can apply damage boost stamina, for example, to one switch glaive skill only, but it can be applied to one skill for every other weapon as well. Pay attention to active skills because they are your biggest damage dealers. Ninjutsu and Onmyo skill points are obtained by using Ninjutsu and Onmyo, well obviously. However, for new players this can be confusing because you start with 0 ninjutsu tools and 0 spells, so you can't use anything. Two ways how to counter that. One way is to use gunpowder and shrapnel bombs as soon as you obtain them to level up ninjutsu. Even though they are consumable items that drop from enemies and not prepared jutsu ones, they still give you ninjutsu points. Same thing for Onmyo, but in this case there are elemental amulets such as fire amulet that you can use that leads to Onmyo points. After that it is only a matter of preparing jutsu and spamming things as much as possible to get many points quickly for both ninjutsu and Onmyo. Second way is to use ninja and Onmyo locks that are found in missions to get free points. Here are some crafting tips to end this video and also tip how to get rid of tons of equipment fast without losing important stuff. What I do to get rid of gear fast is to go to blacksmith and sell everything uncommon or below to get some cash. Then I go to disassemble and disassemble everything that is rare and some unneeded purple gear. That is for early game. Later on, sell everything below purple and disassemble purple and above. Before selling and disassembling, check the stuff so you don't sell gear with max familiarity with great inherent stats you wanted to use for soul matching. Link to soul matching guide, by the way, is in the description because it works the same as in Nioh 1 and I don't want to waste any more of your time in this video. To craft perfect weapon and armor you need to tamper with it. Tampering is fantastic but not as much for early game. As soon as you have your first build that can take you places, then start to play with it. Amber sights are needed for tempering, and those are gained by disassembling gear and then going to forging tools option and making them there. By progressing through the game, higher forging tiers are unlocked. Quick crafting reminder to end the video. Weapons and armor can be forged to purple quality at the beginning of the game, and crafted items are somewhere around your level. So don't neglect that option. especially if you have pre-order bonuses such as Demon and Samurai set that start off very low level, but can be crafted at higher levels through forging option. By using only purple materials, you increase the chance of getting purple item in the end. Higher level materials such as purple can be forged from lower level disassembled materials, same as umber sights. That's all. Now don't go dying on me, you hear?